Good. Now let's talk more about that.
Yes, I think we have now Chairman of the American Conservative Union, Matt Schlapp, who is going to join us to talk about some of the topics that we were just discussing. Matt, it's great to have you with us, as always, of course.
Great to be with you both.
So what should we do about all of these woke corporations, you know, putting their two cents in about all of these issues, kind of jumping on the bandwagon before they know all of the facts?
Yeah, well, that's right, Heather. So what we decided to do at the American Conservative Union is do something conservatives never want to do. We don't want to play as tough or as dirty as the other side. We have manners, and we have always been raised to mind our own business and let people run their companies. But with them canceling half of this country, we can't take those tactics anymore. So we started a new center. We sent letters to the CEO of Delta Airlines, to the commissioner of Major League Baseball, and to the head of the NCAA. And we've heard back from two out of three of those entities. And I think we're already making progress as companies begin to realize if you cancel half of America, you're canceling a lot of your consumers and a lot of your employees, and it's pretty easy not to buy a product that makes you offended.
So you are not asking them to take a conservative position. You just don't want them to take any position?
Well, I mean, they have the right to take the positions they want. But if they're going to come to us and say that identifying who you are as a voter is racist and essentially side with the Democrats on all these political questions, the other half of the country is not going to take that line down. That's an absurd idea that somehow black people can't get IDs, or people of color, it's too hard for them to get IDs, or that you're trying to suppress their vote. Actually, Mark Elias and Stacey Abrams, they've not produced the mountains of evidence that in the last election there was a Republican attempt to suppress black people from voting. Matter of fact, Ted Cruz did the numbers, and it looked like the black communities in Georgia turned out at some of their highest levels. So their charges of racism, voter suppression, are just wrong. And their attempt to destroy girls and women's sports is something else. If the NCAA or other entities continue to try to destroy girls' sports, we'll take them on. And they, matter of fact, they just sent me a letter. I'll break some news here on your show. The NCAA just sent us a letter in response to our ask for a sit down with them so they will cease and desist blackmailing states like North Dakota and South Dakota to allow transgender athletes to compete in girls' sports, biological males to compete in girls and women's sports. And basically their letter says that to have a position of supporting girls' sports is a bigoted position. Well, we're not going to take that lying down. Half the country is not going to take that lying down. And the destruction of girls' sports, I'll tell you one thing, it's going to create a new coalition, because there's a lot of fantastic women athletes who realize that this is wrong.
So, Matt, how do you expect that you will respond to them based on that letter? What will the next move be?
Heather, I think they expect, like most conservatives, we'll be polite, we'll read their letter, and we'll feel like we made our point. Well, we're not going to stop there. If the NCAA continues to go after these Republican governors and pressure them with no more interaction or tournaments with the NCAA, we will break up this coalition that has existed where conservative activists have always supported lower taxes and less regulation, and they've always been supportive of professionalized sports. We're going to break up that coalition. We're going to look for the ways that the federal government and state governments give little benefits to these organizations, and all of that gravy train is going to stop. We are serious about this. We cannot exist as a country when corporate leaders become woke, pick up the mantle of socialists, and destroy norms in our society, including wrecking the chances for my five girls to be able to have their day and compete in sports.
Mm-hmm. Five girls?
Five girls.
I've got two. How do you do five?
Hey, you know what five girls has taught me? It's taught me how to use new tactics with these CEOs, because I've been through it all.
I know. Good luck with that. Yeah. I'll lose every argument, I'm sure.
I have full confidence that it will work. Matt, thank you so much for joining us, and thanks for breaking that news here on Newsmax.
Thanks. Thanks for having me on.
Appreciate it.
Hey, I'm Rob Finnerty. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please join the conversation in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe, too. Hit the bell icon to be alerted to breaking news. And remember, there's a whole lot more on Newsmax TV, America's fastest growing cable news network. Newsmax TV, where real news for real people.